north of Thailand is still a wild and mountainous area. It borders Laos to the east and Burma to the northwest, and it's home to the infamous Golden Triangle. But this part of Burma is not really Burma. It's home to the Shan people, who do not regard themselves as Burmese. They even have their own flag. The Shan, or Thai as they are known in Thailand, are hill farmers. Some spent their time growing opium, and some fought the Burmese army. But some also, over many decades, came to live and stay in northern Thailand, in Mehansong, Chiang Mai, and other places. Here, they can lead a peaceful, secure, and more prosperous life. So much of northern Thailand has a large population of Shan people, who keep up their own traditions, similar to, but distinct from, the Thais. One such tradition is Poi Sang Long, or the Festival of the Crystal Suns, a colourful rite of passage for young boys who enter the monkhood for a short period. It takes place in March or April each year. The exact pattern varies from place to place. In Mehansong, the boys leave from their houses and parade in the street to the Wat. In the Shan state, the boys are traditionally carried on horses or in highly decorated buffalo carts, but the traffic in Chiang Mai won't allow that. Here, the Shan population is spread out and the Wat becomes the home for the three-day festival. The tradition follows Prince Rahula, the son of the Buddha, who became the youngest monk, and the boys are dressed in similar, elaborate princely costumes before ordination. There are two Shan Wats that are popular in Chiang Mai, Wat Koo Tao and Wat Pa Pao. Typically on the first day, the boys' heads are shaved. This is known as tonsure. Monks would have their eyebrows shaved too, but the boys in Chiang Mai are mercifully spared that. First, the parents cut a small piece of hair, then the monk shaves the boy's head. They are then washed and dressed in white clothes in preparation for the parade the next day. The boys are celebrated by their families as little princes, just like Prince Rahula, for 2 days. In the Wats, small houses are constructed and the boys wait, ready for the parade on the second day. In Wat Koo Tao, they dance around the central chedi. In Wat Pa Pao, they are driven around to visit other wats in the city before returning. On each day, there are processions and lots of celebrations, with drumming and music and lots of food. Thank you. It's hot work and tiring. The third day, Hei Krua Lu Day, is the day of ordination. The boys, whose feet must never touch ordinary ground during this festival, even for going to the toilet, and after yet more parades and dancing, are ready for the ordination ceremony. The dancing goes on and on, getting even more frantic, while the women wait patiently at the side. Eventually it stops, and they go into the quiet of the Wuhan, where the ceremony will take place. They change out of their princely robes into the saffron of a monk under the eye of the abbot. There they will stay for a week or more, following Buddhist traditions, before returning to their ordinary life in school. The 3 days are marked by celebration, people coming together to remember who they are and remembering their heritage. It's a very human and happy event. It's sad to see that so much of this spirit has been lost in the West. Let's hope it continues here for many years to come.